And here we have the next 00 Sky Gundam review. This time it is the Trans Am colors as well as the heavy weapon systems. So let's see if this one is better than the Higher in the Sky phase or the normal version. Now this kit is a Trans Am mode, so it's going to be in those typical Trans Am colors, which is very violet and pink. I do think it looks really good. The pink looks very nice. The purple is very, very glossy, which is super cool. And the colors just really contrast and just blend right together. So this is a very looking kit on the surface. But overall, you're just getting the same old 00 Sky as you would with the normal version or the Higher Than Sky phase. The only thing that's really going to be different is, of course, going to be those weapons. But let's go ahead and do a little comparison with another Trans Am Gundam. And here I have is the High Grade 00 Riser Trans Am. Now the colors are going to be vastly different. Instead of violet on the Trans Am Riser, you're going to have like this pretty like maroon looking color, which I think is fairly accurate to its own, you know, anime and universe. But I don't know, I just love the Trans Am colors on this one. It's more bright and vibrant. And that's kind of like something I really love about the 00 Sky, is that it just has a lot of different modes that is very bright and very popping, you know, and just eye-catching overall. So yeah, definitely two different types of Trans Am modes. Maybe it's just because it has the Destiny influences on this kit, so it's not a 100% just 00 Trans Am mode, so that could definitely be an effect. I would love to learn a little bit more about the lore, and if anyone in the comments wants to go ahead and enlighten me, I'm always open to that. Now, if you're looking for articulation, I'm not going to be doing it in this review. I do recommend go ahead and check out some of the other reviews I've made of the 00 Sky, both the normal and the Higher Than Sky, and maybe even check out those pose videos. But I'm going to go ahead and skip the articulation in this video. So with comparisons of all three of the 00 Skies, you're going to have the normal, then moving on to the Trans Am and the Higher Than Sky phase, they're just completely different color kits. I love it. I just absolutely love that you're gonna have this type of variety with all normal release 00 Skies. They're not P Bandai, so you are gonna have some variety with different mixtures of weapons, effect parts. That might be a negative to a lot of people. I know it's a little bit to me, I'm kind of a little turned off to that, but the fact is, I think all three have their own individual merits and their own, you know, kind of like personalities. So maybe it is kind of worth getting, you know, maybe two or all three of them. But yeah, that is going to be up to you. Now this kit also comes with some extra little attachments, so if you have other kits that just have like a single peg backpack or a dual peg backpack, you can plug these right into the backside of those little kits, and then you could plug the backpack of this kit right here, so it would be 100% compatible. Now this kit is also going to come with every single accessory that the original 00 Sky came with. So you are going to have the Buster Sword, you are going to have the Long Beam Rifle, and the Basic Beam Rifle, along with the Beam Saber effect parts and the Beam Saber hilts. This can also go into its little lash mode where you put the backpack down, and it has a more melee oriented style. So nothing really new here, but let's finally move on to what makes this kit so much different. And that being the heavy weapon system. Now this is going to consist of the Lancer missile, the missile pods, as well as the missile launchers. So all this is going to soon be equipped to our 00 Sky, and it is going to look super massive. So let's go ahead and just add on the backpack first. And how you're going to want to do that is first take off this little section right there, and then you're just going to peg the backpack inside, and bam, and here it is with the backpack attached. I do love the lance launchers, I love the missile pods. This is probably actually my favorite part about the whole heavy weapon system. And we are going to get into what is, I consider, not the strongest point of it. I think it kind of looks a little goofy, but the little missile launchers that attach to the arms as well as the legs, we're gonna go ahead and start looking at that right now. And here you have them, but To my taste, I don't think they're that great looking. The color, you know, is fine. I think the blue, the pink contrast is very well. It looks good nonetheless, but I just think the way that they're placed is kind of weird. Maybe that's just me, but yeah, let's go ahead and start mounting these on the arms and legs. And with all the missile pods and the heavy weapon And with the missile pods and everything attached, it looks good. It looks really good, actually. So the ones on the gauntlets, I think that's fine. I think those look pretty good. They're generally pointing in a very safe direction at all times, much like the ones on the backpack. But the ones on the legs, those are the ones I would have a problem with because they're always pointing directly to the suit. So you're going to have to bend your legs to shoot them, unless like there's a mechanism that basically brings them down and they can fire on their own. But in at least in its resting mode right there, it's pointing at the mobile suit itself, so that's kind of a safety hazard. Not something I would really want on my personal mobile suit, whether it be kit or real life. So yeah, I think it looks good and definitely can pave way for some good dynamic poses. Now with the other weapons attached, this is going to just be completely overpowered. It's going to have a nice long range attack with the beam rifle, the long beam rifle I should say. It's going to have some good melee with that sword in case some enemies get close, and with all the missile pods and the Lancer missile, it's just good. It's just all around goodness. Now in order to keep this big boy up, you're going to have this little stand. So and if you just don't want to fork over the money, this will come with the stand, and that's going to prevent you from actually spending a little extra money. So good on Bandai, but I kind of wish it was the better quality stand that we had with the Higher in the Sky phase. And if you put the heavy weapon system onto the normal 00 Sky, I think it looks good. I kind of wish the colors were a little bit darker in the like in the illustration, but that's something you could definitely paint. So it's pretty cool. I like it. I just think if you paint the colors a little bit darker, it's gonna look super super cool. Whether it be like a very dark blue or black or maybe even gray, it's colors are gonna look really good and contrast very well with the already dark blue on the kit. Now, if you was wondering if the Higher in the Sky phase effect parts were compatible, you would be correct. This is going to be very, very big. It just keeps growing, whether in length or in width, and it looks massively beautiful. I love everything about it. It's kind of cluttered, I would say, maybe especially with the legs. But nonetheless, this is going to be extremely, extremely awesome. And just having the giant Buster Sword right there, everything about it is going to look fantastic. So whether it's cluttered or not cluttered, this is definitely going to be a great addition to your shelf. Also, it comes with all the same accessories that the original 00 Sky came with, which is very surprising to be honest. I was really not thinking that it was going to come with the same exact weapons, but very much glad it does. So if you really want to start posing in a different type of poses, whether with the Buster Sword like I really love to do, or with the long beam rifle, you can easily pull those off as well. So in terms of cons, well, I don't really have too many. What I would just have to say, which may not be much of criticism, but more of an observation, is that it doesn't try to reinvent anything with this model. It's more just enhancements. So with the backpack and the color, it just kind of adds to something that we already have. That's, to me, one of the best high grades of 2018. So you're not taking away anything, you're just kind of adding to, and that's just what makes this really work. So I can't really say if anything con wise, but if you do have some cons and maybe something that you just don't really like about this kit, please let me know, whether it be colors or just the accessories or lackluster. But nonetheless, definitely appreciate all of you for watching, and like always, please rate, comment, subscribe when you have the chance, and I'll be seeing you guys in the next review. Bye bye.